This week, members of the Minneapolis City Council asked for a delay by the city in the clearing of another homeless encampment. This one is in South Minneapolis by the Phillips Community Center. John Croman went to that encampment this afternoon and joins us with the latest. Hi, John.
Hey, Jana. You know, the city council members who signed that letter say they feel this camp is more organized and better run than the other encampments they've seen. So I decided to go there and speak to the person who's kind of been in charge there for the last 113 days.
Long-term homeless and was just housed last week.
What's Nicole like to work with?
She's fun. She can get mad easy.
Nicole Mason is the unofficial mayor of Nenookaasi, the encampment that stretches for almost a city block along 13th Avenue in South Minneapolis, a tent village that has stood for 4 months on vacant land owned by the city.
I am here with the hope that the outcome will be to help a lot of people get into recovery.
Nicole is a recovered addict, an indigenous woman who sees the encampment as a culturally sensitive first stop for people trying to shake addiction and move on to more stable housing situations.
We've welcomed all housing outreach to come in and work and to work with the residents and see how they can help them.
But the city views Nenookaasi as a public health hazard in need of being removed, with evictions slated to begin next week, December 14th.
We could be looking at a potential infectious disease outbreak. And because we're not able to really get in there with any of emergency services, we would have a hard time and a challenging time addressing something if it were to happen.
Heidi Ritchie is the deputy health commissioner for the city, and Enrique Velasquez is the regulatory services director. They say the city has partnered with Helix Health Services to find housing for 40 residents already, and another 52 are slated to be placed in housing next week.
They're not just numbers. These are our community. And we're trying to do as much as we can and as best as we can to uplift them and help them move into a different space.
The city also shared police reports of a shooting, a DOA case, and the death of a preterm baby inside the camp.
Let us keep the people contained in one spot where outreach workers are able to find them, healthcare outreach workers can find them, mental health can find them.
Allies of the encampment filled City Hall Tuesday night to rally against eviction of indigenous people. And a couple of days later, 8 members of the city council wrote a letter to Mayor Jacob Frey asking him to delay evictions until February 16th.
Why evict then? We've never said we wanted to stay forever. We just want to house enough people. We just need more time to be able to house the majority of the people.
Now, Nicole said she's been working with a lot of the outreach groups and trying to, you know, take part in this whole process of placing people and getting them out of that encampment. Several Native American organizations here in the city have written letters in support of Mayor Frey trying to remove this encampment. They say it's better to get people out of there and to wrap around services. There's also the fear that as people leave that encampment, Jana, that others will come in to replace them so that it never, ever really goes away.
John, any word from Mayor Frey about that letter those council members sent asking to delay? Does he plan to even think about that?
Well, as of news time, no. And that's why today earlier we saw some people show up with a symbolic eviction notice for Mayor Frey, evicting him from the city. But that's just kind of another just thing they're doing just to call more attention to this issue. But the city's long-term plan for this land is to put a wellness center there centered on Native American indigenous people.
All right. Thanks so much, John. Appreciate it.